most of the times hypertension is asymptomatic. That means patient can't understand whether he or she is having hypertension. So it is always better to check your blood pressure. Even if it is normal, then at least follow it up every 3 to 5 yearly. And many a times patient can have symptoms like headache, pain in the neck, sometimes palpitation, even respiratory distress during exercise or activities. And if patient presents with complications due to hypertension, then he can have symptoms of chest pain and even stroke. Now, basically, nowadays it is quite different with respect to various guidelines. Because earlier we used to stage it from stage 1 to stage 4. But whereas now it is said if the blood pressure is less than 140/90, it is stage 1. If it is more than that, it is stage 2. Treatment of hypertension doesn't start from medicine only. It starts from adequate lifestyle management that includes regular exercise and stress relief or relaxation, some amount of good amount of sleep along with then low salt intake, and also to control the comorbidities associated with hypertension like as cholesterol or sugar. And regarding treatment, there are different types of antihypertensive drugs are available. Doctors usually prescribe them according to the need of the patient, and the patient will have to take it regularly and also to monitor blood pressure regularly. Age is basically a big risk factor. Apart from that, if the patient is having a family history of hypertension, then many a times patient may get hypertension with age. But to some extent, nowadays hypertension has become an epidemic, so it is always better to screen at least ourselves regularly. And there is some entity called secondary hypertension, where different disease is associated and causing hypertension, like the patient is having chronic kidney disease, sometimes thyroid dysfunction, sometimes some adrenal tumors. Even in these cases, blood pressure may become high.